on this Ham Dickens! 5 door 6 to Scranton, Ham Dickens!
5 minutes, thank you.
Yes!
How's my makeup?
It's not Christmassy enough. Hans!
Yep.
We need this to look more Christmassy.
Yep.
Excellent! Do hurry! I will not have my one big night ruined by some English actor!
Hello, and happy holidays. We British like a ghost story at Christmas time. It is, after all, a bittersweet remembrance time. It is a time when the veil between this world and the next is thinnest. Come, let us lift that veil. Come, let us lift that veil.
That is on you. Lift the veil. Lift the veil.
Yep.
Marley was dead. This must be clearly understood, or nothing wonderful can come of the story I'm about to relate to you. But Ebenezer Scrooge, he was a tight-fisted, hand-to-the-grindstone Scrooge.
Good day, my dear Scrooge. How are you?
I'm here. Come closer. Closer. Humbug. Keep your distance.
That hurt.
That really hurt.
Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
You urchins. Be gone with you.
And a Happy New Year.
Cratchit, no more coal today. It's expensive.
But Mr. Scrooge, it's so beastly cold.
No more coal. Now, get back to work.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Oh.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Infernal cattle woman.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a
Stop
happy-
it! Stop that singing down there, or I shall call the magistrate.
Sorry, sir. I'll wait quietly.
A Merry Christmas to you, Uncle Scrooge. God bless you.
Humbug.
Christmas a humbug? Now come, Uncle. Don't be cross.
What else can I be when I live in such a world of fools? Merry Christmas, sir. If I could work my will, every idiot that goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips would be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
Oh, come now, Uncle.
You keep Christmas your way and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it, but you don't keep it at all.
Let me leave it alone, then. What good Christmas has ever done anyone?
Why, Uncle, I believe Christmas has done me a great deal of good. I see Christmas as a joyful time, a cheerful time, a charitable time. It is the only time I know when men and women seem to open their hearts to each other freely. So therefore, though it has never put a scrap of gold in my pocket, I believe it has done me good and will do me good. So I say, God bless it.
Hear, hear. Splendid, sir. Splendid.
One more word out of you, Cratchit, and you shall celebrate your Christmas by losing your situation. You are a powerful speaker, Fred. I'm surprised you haven't run for Parliament.
Now, Uncle, don't be that way. Come. Join me and my family for a Christmas skating party tomorrow.
Oh, go to the devil.
Why does our invitation make you so cross? Come be with me and my wife.
Oh, your wife. Your wife. Why did you marry in the first place, anyways?
Well, we love each other. I love her and she loves me.
Love her! Bah, good afternoon.
Well, I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so resolute, but I shall keep my humor to the last. So a Merry Christmas to you, Uncle.
Good afternoon.
And a Happy New Year.
Good afternoon.
Merry Christmas to you, Bob.
Thank you, sir. God bless you. And Merry Christmas.
Cratchit.
Oh, have I the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley? Mr. Marley has been dead these 7 years.
He died 7 years ago this very night.
I am Mr. Fox, and this is Mr. Barlow, and we are, as I'm sure you know, representing the Society of Friends.
Mr. Scrooge, at this festive season of the year, we like to make some slight provision for the poor and destitute, as they are suffering greatly.
Are there no prisons?
Plenty of prisons.
And the workhouses and the soup kitchens, are they still in operation?
They are. I wish I could say they were not. They scarcely provide.
I was afraid by what you were saying, something had happened to stop their usefulness. I'm glad to hear it.
However, they scarcely furnish Christian cheer of mind or body to the multitude, sir. A few of us are endeavoring to raise some funds to allow the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth. What shall I put you down for?
Nothing.
Nothing?
You wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. My taxes pay for those establishments that I spoke of, and those who are badly off must go there.
Many cannot go there. They would rather die.
Well, if they would rather die, they better do it and decrease the surplus population.
I'm very busy. Good afternoon.
But, Mr. Scrooge...
Good afternoon! Be gone with you! Oh, now they've made me late. Cratchit, I'm off to the exchange.
Don't lock up a moment early. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
You want all day off tomorrow, I suppose.
If quite convenient, sir.
It's not convenient, and it's not fair. If I were to stop half a day's wages, you would be feeling ill-used, I suppose.
Oh, sir.
And yet you don't think me ill-used when I pay a full day's wages for no work.
It's only one day, sir.
Poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. Well, if you must have the whole day off, be it so. But be here all the earlier the next day. Do you understand?
Yes, sir. Very clear, sir. Thank you, sir. And Merry Christmas!
Christmas? Bah! Humbug!
Bills to collect, renters to evict, and then home.
Ebenezer Scrooge!
Marley.
Ebenezer Scrooge!
Oh, there's no such thing as ghosts. There's no such thing as ghosts. Superstitious nonsense, that's all it is. Oh, my heart.
Good evening.
Oh! Heavens to Betsy! Why are you skulking about in the shadows?
Sorry, sir. Didn't mean to give you a fright.
What are you trying to do? Scare the liver and the lights out of me? Why do I pay a housekeeper for? It seems awfully warm in here. Have you been... stockpiling the coal again?
No, sir. Not at all, sir.
Put out that light! Who pays for the light around here? There's plenty of light coming from the window by that infernal street lamp. Where's my robe?
Here, sir. Freshly laundered.
Give it to me.
Are you joining us for Christmas tomorrow, Molly?
I can't. I have to work.
But it's Christmas.
Just a moment.
There was a half a crown in the pocket of this robe, and it's missing. Where is it? Did you take it?
I would never.
Sir, perhaps it's in your other robe pocket.
Perhaps. But it better be found soon, or else I'll have you before the magistrate.
We'll find it, sir, but it's late. The light.
By the morning. Do you hear me? By the morning, or the magistrate.
Devil bring you home.
What did you say?
Nothing, sir. Just some people on the street below. Good night, Mr. Scrooge. Good night, Mrs. Meechan. Don't worry about the coin. We'll find it one way or the other.
Molly, how can you work for such...
The sky is strange, and the walls have ears. Now on home with you, dearie. All will be well. My word, he's far more skittish than normal. Double lock the doors? Maybe there are ghosts and fairies about.
Scrooge.
What?
Ebenezer Scrooge.
Ghosts? Humbug. Humbug. Oh.
Ebenezer Scrooge.
What are you? Who are you?
In life, I was your partner, Jacob Marley. You don't believe in me.
I don't. Because the slightest effect of the stomach affects the senses. You may be a bit of beef, a crumb of cheese, an overdone bit of potato. There's more gravy than grave of you, whatever you are. Humbug, I say.
Scrooge!
Oh, Jacob, Jacob, mercy, Jacob. You're fettered, Jacob. Why?
I wear the chains I forged in life. I made them link by link, and yard by yard. Is its pattern strange to you? Or would you know the length and weight of the coil you bear yourself? It was as long and as heavy as this 7 Christmases ago. You have labored on it since. 'Tis a ponderous chain.
Oh, speak comfort to me, old Jacob.
I have none to give. It comes from other regions, Ebenezer. I am here tonight to warn you that you have a chance and hope of escaping my fate.
Oh, you are always a good friend to me. Thank you, Jacob.
You will be haunted by 3 spirits.
Is that the chance and the hope that you're speaking of? I think I'd rather not.
Without their visits, you cannot help to escape the path I tread. Expect the first tonight, when the bell tolls 1.
Well, couldn't I take them all at once and get it over with?
Expect the second, on the next night, when the bell tolls 2. Expect the third, on the next night, when the last stroke of midnight ceases to vibrate. Look to see me no more, Ebenezer. And for your own sake, remember what has passed between us. Remember! Remember!
Oh, humbug!
With a sparkling glow, as if a falling star had kissed the new-fallen snow, the first of the 3 nightly visitors appeared. Its blinding light danced about the room as if 1,000 fireflies had given flight, awakening Scrooge.
One. Was it not on the stroke of 1 a spirit was to appear? Where is he? I see nothing. Oh. Just a trick of mine.
A magical Christmas to you.
What are you?
Would you mind turning down the light? It hurts my eyes.
Blind folks see fairies far better than thee, who miss the shining of their wings because their eyes are filled with things they do not wish to see. I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Of long past.
No.
Your past.
My... Bah, humbug.
Why are you here?
Your welfare.
My welfare?
Your reclamation.
Well,
If you're concerned about my welfare, a good night's sleep would be much better for my welfare.
Ah! Handbag!
Come! Rise!
Whoa.
And
whoa.
Walk with
whoa.
Me!
Help!
Spirit, where are we?
Do you recollect the way?
I could do it blindfolded.
And the leprechaun said to Darby, if you set me three, I'll grant you three wishes. Oh, I wish I could go home.
I was so lonely.
You were deserted by your family and friends.
My mother had passed away, and my father held a grudge.
Why did he hold a grudge?
My mother died in childbirth. My birth.
Weep for the boy, if tears will come. No, I thought not. Come then, another Christmas.
Do you know this place?
Why, I was an apprentice here. Ho, ho, ho! It's Fezziwig. Mr. Fezziwig alive again.
Yo ho, boys, come here.
Come on, Mr. Fezziwig. Are you quite all right, sir?
Oh, perfectly all right. Just practicing my entrance. I'm Father Christmas, you know. Ho, ho, ho.
Yeah, it's quite hoey.
No more work today, Ebenezer. That's quite enough, Jacob. Do you know the day?
Yes, sir. It's December the 24th.
To be sure. So no more work today. Shut down the machines. Clear away the floors. Place a candle in every window so everyone knows they are welcome here. Come now, Jacob. Have up the shelves.
Why do I always have to do it?
Oh, clear the hearth for the Yule log. Hurry up, my boys. Lovey Dovey is on her way now.
Understood, sir.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, there's nothing we wouldn't have done for Mr. Fezziwig. We were more than employees, stoking the fire, turning the wheel. We were more like family. Oh, Mrs. Fezziwig. And Belle. I forgot how pretty Belle was.
Not ready, Mr. Fezziwig. The guests will be here any minute. Where are the musicians? Where are the gifts?
Oh, they're here. They're just, they're just getting ready.
Oh, yeah, they're doing that.
Here, Mama, some fresh mistletoe.
Just what this party needs, love.
Look how festive the hall is, Mama.
Magical. And look how beautiful you are tonight, Belle. Perhaps we will find that perfect match for you at the party.
Mama, don't go on like that. Dances are not for finding husbands, and daughters are not for forming family alliances.
Well, tell that to Cinderella. And where do you think I found your father? Under the mistletoe.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. 'Tis the season. Love. Christmas. It's all around us. My dear, how would you like a dance?
Oh, I would love to.
Belle, would you do me the honors of having this first dance?
Yes, that would be nice.
Ooh, someone's got a girlfriend.
Looks like you have a cat.
I told you to leave me alone.
How long since you've danced, Ebenezer?
Useless rubbish.
You didn't think so then.
Then I had a reason.
Come then, another Christmas, the same party, but several years later.
Oh, Ebenezer, how light upon your feet you are. What a change has come over you these past few weeks.
Well, my life has truly changed for the better. Perhaps there is some truth in the magic of Christmas Eve, or perhaps it is just you.
Me? Certainly I have not become the silly idol of your pursuits.
No, not silly at all, I assure you. I'm a man of a serious mind.
Seriousness is an admirable trait, but it can be overdone. Life must be lived and enjoyed.
Well, then I shall take heed to your advice and go through life with a smile on my face.
My, my, Ebenezer, you are full of Christmas spirit tonight.
Well, I'm caught up in the magic of the evening, and so is everyone else. I mean, look at how happy they all are.
A small matter to make such silly folk full of gratitude. He has spent but a few pounds of your mortal money. Is it so great that he deserves such gratitude?
Oh, it's not that, Spirit. It's not that. He had the power to make our lives happy or miserable. He had the power to make our labor light or burdensome. The happiness he gave was as great as if it cost him a fortune.
Remember the past as you will, but come, forward in time, to yet another Christmas. You were delayed by the pressures of business.
Oh, no. No.
Do you remember this one?
No, not that one. Why has it gotten so cold and so dark?
I thought you might not come. I know how busy you are, even during Christmas.
Well, this is an extremely busy time for me. It's important that I use my opportunities wisely.
It matters little to you. Another idol has replaced me. I hope it will comfort you in times to come, as I hope I could have comforted you myself.
What idol has replaced you?
A golden one. I've seen your noble ideas fall off one by one. Until the master passion gained profit has engrossed you, have I not?
Well, there's nothing in this world as hard as poverty.
You fear the world too much. You hold money more important than me and anything else in the world.
It's true that I've grown wiser, stronger, and more successful, but it hasn't changed my opinion towards you.
Oh, you have.
Don't be ridiculous, Belle. Have I ever sought release from our engagement?
In words, no, never.
In what, then?
In a changed nature and altered spirit. If you're free today, tomorrow, yesterday, can I even believe that you would choose a dowerless girl that brings nothing to this marriage?
Tell her, boy. Tell her the truth.
You have no answer.
You think I would not?
What a safe and terrible answer. So characteristic of a careful and soulless businessman you have become. If we continued, regret sure would follow. What do you care for these days?
Tell her you love her!
I am sorry.
Ebenezer, I release you. With the full heart of love that you once were. Goodbye, Ebenezer. May you truly be happy with the life you have
chosen. I almost went after her.
Almost carries no weight, especially in matters of the heart.
Spirit, remove me from this place. Haunt me no longer. I cannot bear it.
Would you so put out the light I bring? The past lives, Ebenezer. The past lives. Return if you believe better dreams may follow. The past lives. The past lives. The past lives.
Two o'clock. Was it not upon the stroke of two? Dear Marley, you were mistaken in death as you were in life. 2 o'clock.
Ebenezer!
What?
Ebenezer Scrooge! Come in! Come in and know me better, man! I am the ghost of Christmas present.
Ghost. You're the ghost who is to conduct me where you will.
I trust you will profit from our journey.
I would profit better with a good night's sleep, but... as you will.
Mark well this night. Touch my robe, and we shall journey on as spirits on this longest night of the year to see if the sun shall return.
Birds for sale! Get your holiday meal from the best. The award-winning goose still with its ribbon on. Only here.
Oh. Look what I got!
Oh, apples! Thank you, Belinda!
And I got some sugar for your Christmas pudding, Mama. I can hardly wait.
Oh, yummy. Thank you, Peter. Thank you, children. But, now where is your sister Martha? She was to help me with the goose.
There's Martha now, Mommy.
So sorry. I was afraid I wouldn't make it in time. I was finishing a great deal of work at the Woodhams getting their house ready for Christmas.
Well, bless your sainted heart, how late you are. And we should never be apart from family at Christmas. But never mind now. So long as you're here, Lord love you. Now, what has gotten into your father?
Probably.
It's so late.
Probably being kept late by that old Scrooge.
Oh, don't I know, Martha. But, oh, the goose. Oh, I'd almost forgotten.
Forget the goose. Oh, Mother.
We're having goose?
No pepper soup tonight.
Yay!
Now, how many will you be feeding, Mama? The one right here would feed everyone nicely.
Oh, I don't think we can afford that one. Children, do you have any money left over?
I have 2 pennies left, Mommy.
I have 1.
And I have my Christmas bonus.
Oh, this is splendid, children. Thank you. Now, let's see. We will take this one here on the end.
Oh, no, not that one. You'll barely feed yourself. Beg your pardon. Especially since you're expecting. When are you due, ma'am?
Any day now. Oh, maybe my Christmas present. But I'm afraid this one is all we can afford.
It's a fine goose, Mommy.
Sure is. The very best.
Thank you, Peter. Oh, I think I see your father.
Yay,
yes,
father.
Yes, Daddy.
Hello, children.
Hello, Daddy.
Oh, greetings, Hi. Dear. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas. And how did Tim behave?
Oh, as good as gold and better.
We went to St. Michael's for Vespers, and he gets so thoughtful sitting there. He thinks of the strangest things. Tim, what did you say coming over here?
I hope the people at the church saw me because I'm a cripple. It might be pleasant for them to remember upon Christmas Day he made the lame beggars walk and the blind men see.
Oh, Tim, you have such a warm heart.
Here's a glass of cider to warm you, children.
That's very nice, but I'm afraid we can't afford
it. Oh, it's a holiday special. Free with every bird purchase.
Oh,
my. You all have been busy. What a bird. And what a feast we shall have. No pepper soup tonight.
Yay!
Oh, it's Mr. Scrooge. I give you Mr. Scrooge, the founder of the feast.
Hear, hear. Shh, Scrooge.
The founder of the feast, indeed. I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon, and I hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
Oh, my dear, the children. Christmas Day.
It should be Christmas Day, I'm sure, on which one drinks to such an odorous, hard, unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Bob. No one knows it better than you, and
Oh, my dear, are you all right? Deep breaths. We won't want the baby to be born here in the snow.
Maybe Mommy can have him in the horse stable like baby Jesus.
That's a terrible idea.
No, it's not.
I can't wait to be a big brother.
I'm fine, my dears, I'm fine. It's not time yet.
Well, very well. To Christmas, to Mr. Scrooge, to family present, and on the way.
I'll drink to his health, for your sake, Bob's, and the day's, but not his. Long life to him, a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I'm sure he'll be very merry and very happy, I'm sure.
Oh, well, a Merry Christmas to all my dears. God bless us.
Merry Christmas. God bless us.
God bless us, everyone.
Spirit. That, the small one, the crippled one. Tiny Tim.
Yeah. Tim?
Yes. Will he live?
I see an empty chair in a poor chimney corner. I see a crutch without an owner carefully preserved. If the shadows remain unaltered by the future, the child shall die.
Oh, no, spirit.
If the shadows remain unaltered by the future. None of my race will find him here.
Tim must not die.
What then? If he be to die, he better do it, and quickly. Decrease
the surplus population.
Spirit, you haunt me with my own words. I know your torment isn't over yet, so lead on.
Man, if man you be of heart, forbear your wickedness until you know what the surplus population is and where it is. Touch my robe, and we shall journey on.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
No! No!
Oh, my snowman!
Oh, dear! Oh, go ahead. Laugh it up. Oh, I got snow all over me. Oh, humbug.
How dare you? He said Christmas was a humbug.
No, not me. That's what my uncle always says. That's a humbug, I say. Nothing more than a humbug. As I live and breathe. And he believed it, too.
Oh, he's a comical old fellow. With all that money, every day is Christmas.
George, that's just the very thing. He doesn't do anything with his money. He doesn't even make himself comfortable with it.
If you mean wasting it by throwing extravagant parties, I...
Scrooge! You are wasting your precious breath. They cannot hear you. Hush, listen, and maybe learn.
Well, I feel sorry for him.
Sorry for me?
Shh! I could be sorry with him if I tried. Who suffers by his ill whims?
Himself, always. Well, here he takes it into his head to dislike us. He refuses to come skate with us, and what are the consequences?
The loss of races, which I always win. Log jumping, which I am the very best.
Oh, you're so wonderful.
Oh, at a great meal and a famous party afterwards.
Well, I mean to give him the same chance every year, whether he likes it or not.
And every year he will say,
Christmas! Bah, humbug! Well, Mr. Topper, if you're so geared at Yule log jumping, how about another race then? And the first one over gets first dibs on that Christmas pudding.
Oh, I can taste victory already.
On and on they traveled, visiting Christmases both small and grand, all showcasing Christmas time as a time of gratitude, generosity, and goodwill.
Spirit, forgive me, but you seem to have aged a great deal during our journey. Are spirits' lives so short?
My life upon this globe is very brief. It ends tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight at midnight. Hark, the time grows near.
Spirit, I notice something strange. Protruding from your robe that does not belong to you. Is it a hand or a claw?
Look here. Look down here.
Spirit, are they yours?
They are man's, but they cling to me. The boy is ignorance. The girl is want. Beware them both, but most of all, beware this boy.
Have they no refuge, no resources?
Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?
Spirit, don't leave me here! Don't leave me, it's a strange place! Spirit!
It's too late.
Spirit, no!
yet to come. Oh, ghosts of the future, I fear you more than anything. Lead on. Lead on.
When did he die?
Sometime after midnight, I believe.
I thought he would never die. I wonder what he did with all his money.
I don't know. Left it to his company, perhaps.
One thing's for certain, he didn't leave any to me. It would be a cheap funeral. I don't know anyone who'd want to go to it.
Where are you taking me? I've never been to this pouch of town before.
Ah! Rats!
You called?
Step lively. Don't pause. Tis not the place to linger. Follow me. This way, quickly.
Oh, look. Another beautiful day. Makes me sick.
Joe, look what I've got.
Shh, keep it down. We don't want old jolly old London finding out about it, do we? Now, look, what have you got?
Look, it's a pocket watch, one of them newfangled ones.
Ooh, what a fat, grateful little thief you are. If you scratch that little S right off, that's really worth something. Now, get off with you. Here comes some bigger fish. You and me, a little rot, out of here. Well. If it ain't the laundress, the undertaker, and the housemaid. Such fine and fair a day, I can't say I ever seen.
What are the chances, old Joe? What are the chances? If we three haven't met without meeting it.
Borrowing from swine.
Indeed. So, what have you got to sell for me?
Half a minute's patience, Joe, and you'll see.
I don't know about this. I've never taken anything before, I mean.
Hush now. You didn't take it from anyone who needed it anymore.
But what if the constable should see us?
What are the odds, Molly? The police never come here.
Come into the parlor, said the spider to the fly. If you fear the gallows.
Who's the worse for the loss of a few things?
Let's see here. Some bunch of spoons. Silver ring and, pocket linen. There. There's your account.
What? That's a right. Silver ring. It should be worth...
Emil! Who's next?
Mrs. O'Shaughnessy.
Excellent.
Those are my things. I'll have them before a magistrate. Oh! Such greed! Such avarice!
Ice skates. Very fine indeed. Some more spoons. He certainly had a lot of spoons. And three candle stumps. What do I want these for?
Well, they were all that's left of the funeral candles. They burnt down quite a bit in 3 days. I stayed there by myself the whole time.
You? You were keening?
Well, me being a Christian lady and there being no one else and... Besides, I couldn't afford no professional keeners.
Yeah, that's all fine and well, but then, this is right now, that's fine. And guess what I found in the pocket? Right here, half a crown. Very fine, half a crown indeed.
Oh, no, that's mine. I earned it.
Oh, really?
It's lucky coin. No, give that back.
Back? You mean they're gonna bury him with coins over his arm?
It's tradition!
He's dead, so I'm guessing his luck ran out.
Well, that should be about your account.
Sixpence, but I know he paid so
all
much
right,
money.
All right, take the whole thing. Gives too much to the ladies anyway.
If he wanted to keep him after he's dead, that wicked old screw, why wasn't he kinder in his lifetime?
Then I propose a toast. Here's to the wicked old screw then and to all vultures like us.
Spirit, I have seen all that I need to see. Take me home. Spirit, before I look upon that headstone,
Tell me, are these the shadows of things that will be, or the shadows of things that may be? Ebenezer Scrooge! Ebenezer Scrooge! No! I'm not that man! Why show me these things if I'm past all hope? I'm not that man! No! I'm not that man! I'm not that man! I'm not that man! I'm not that man! I'm not the man I was. I'm not the man I was. I'm not the man I... I'm here. Hello? Who's there?
Why, it's Molly, sir. I'm begging your pardon, sir, but I thought I heard you up and about, and I brought you breakfast and... Oh, Mr. Scrooge! You're not decent.
Oh, I hope not. I hope not. What day is it? What day is it?
Well, today?
Yes.
Why, it's Christmas Day.
Christmas
begging
Day.
Your pardon, sir.
Christmas Day? Why... The spirits have done it all in one night. Well, of course they can. They can do anything that they want to in one night, can't they?
Are you quite yourself, sir?
Oh, I hope not. I hope not. Oh, it's Christmas. It's Christmas Day.
Sir, you're not well. Let me fetch the doctor.
No. Not the doctor. Not the undertaker. It's Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Oh, dear me. All the saints and blessed martyrs. He's got madness.
Please. How much do I pay you?
A pound a month, sir.
Double it. What? You deserve a raise. You're worth every penny.
Oh, dear, it's worse than I thought.
Now go on. Go on. Enjoy yourself. It's Christmas.
A Merry Christmas to you, Mr. Scrooge.
Merry Christmas.
It's a Christmas miracle. Saints be praised. Thank you, Mr. Scrooge. Thank you.
Christmas. Oh, I don't know what to do with myself. I'm as happy as a schoolboy. I'm as giddy as a drunken man. Oh, Merry Christmas!
Well, and after I finish these snow angels, I'll make a snowman and it'll never fall down.
Hello! Oh. Hello, my fine fellow.
Hi.
What day is it?
It's Christmas Day. What else would it
Christmas
be?
Christmas Day. What an intelligent lad you are. Oh, it is Christmas Day.
Sir, who are you talking to?
Do you know the poulterer in the next street?
Well, I sure hope I did it. Wait a minute. Shouldn't you be wearing clothes? You'll catch your death.
Oh, what a delightful lad you are. I want you to go and buy the turkey.
The prize-winning one?
Oh, yes. Not the small one. The big one.
Swag.
No. I'm in earnest. If you go and buy it and bring it here, I'll give you a shilling. If you come back before 5 minutes is up, I'll give you half a crown.
Half a crown, yes, sir!
Oh, what a delightful lad. I'll send the goose to Bob Cratchit. He'll never know who sent it. Oh, it's twice the size of Tiny Tim. Snow angels! Whee! Oh, it's wonderful to be alive. Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Hello, sir. Back in 2 minutes. Sir?
Well, where is he, boy?
I don't know.
This better not be some kind of joke.
But he was right there. I swear.
If I carried this giant goose all the way over here and no one can afford it, I'll box your
Merry
ears.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas,
oh,
you,
Merry
sir.
You made it. You made it before 5 minutes. Oh, my goodness. What a wonderful goose. Oh, this is a prize. Yes, the biggest prize goose I have ever seen. Twice the size of Tiny Tim.
Who's Tiny Tim?
Anyhow, I want you to take this all the way to St. Giles. I wish to be anonymous. Oh, do you understand? I wish to be anonymous.
Right, sir. Mr. Anonymous. Bob Cratchit, 47 St. John. That part of town, sir? Oh, slag. Oh,
I understand. You can't carry that bird all the way to St. Giles.
You need to have a cab.
A cab?
Take a cab.
But, sir, taking a cab into...
Here. This is enough for the cab and the bird and a bit of nice change for a Christmas bonus to you, sir. Merry Christmas.
Why, sir, Merry Christmas. You are more than generous. Thank you, sir.
Remember, anonymous. I wish to be anonymous. Merry Christmas. Here, my boy. I want you to have this.
A whole crown?
For a prince of a fellow.
Thank you, sir. Merry Christmas, sir! Dad, look what
Merry
I got!
Merry Christmas! Oh, Merry Christmas! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way! Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! We wish you a Merry Christmas! We wish you a Merry... Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas to you both! Oh, thank you so much for coming to my office yesterday. I hope you were successful in your mission.
Mr. Scrooge?
I know. I realize my name is not very pleasant to you. I beg your forgiveness, and I ask you to accept this.
Lord bless me.
My dear Scrooge, are you serious?
Oh, yes. Yes, and not a farthing less. There are a great many back payments in that, I assure you. But will you come and see me after Christmas?
We will, sir. We will indeed.
Oh, splendid. Splendid. Merry Christmas to you both.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge.
Oh, thank you. Merry Christmas. It's wonderful to be alive. Oh, wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
That was a wonderful Christmas service. What was everyone's favorite part of Mass?
Well, I like the bishop's new Christmas robes and the sandwiches. I still have part of mine, but hey, where'd it go?
It was delicious.
Belinda!
Children.
I liked how the sun shined through the stained glass, and it shined a kaleidoscope of colors on my new dress.
Aww.
Yes. I liked the Christmas story the best.
Yes, it was all very beautiful, but... Bob, you were falling asleep. You should spend tomorrow at home resting and being with our family.
Oh, come now. We all know that's not possible. Mr. Scrooge.
Look, it's the prize-winning goose.
I wonder who could have bought that enormous goose.
Oh. Wow. Good morning. Can we help you? Are you lost?
Yes, thank you. I've never had a delivery to this part of town. Beg your pardon. I've got a delivery for Mr. Bob Cratchit, 47 St. Giles.
Oh, not Bob, in this part of
it's
town.
It's for you.
Yes, for me. Surely not. Who could have sent it?
Mr. A. Anonymous.
Saints be praised.
Merry Christmas. I must be going. My son is in the cab, and I don't want the cab to leave without us. I refuse to come any further than two streets up.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, of course.
Excuse me, sir. What does that ribbon say?
First prize, grand champion.
Oh.
Here you go, son.
Wait,
you can take this bird here.
Oh, be careful, Peter. Careful. Oh.
Look, a big bird.
Careful, Peter.
Yes.
That's our Christmas dinner.
Yes. I can't feel my arms.
Why are you laughing?
He's Samson.
I wonder who really sent it, though.
Well, let's see here. Mr. Anonymous. Anonymous. Anonymous! Yes!
Oh, yes. I wonder who really sent it, though.
I think I know.
Who do you think?
Mr. Scrooge.
Oh, my dear, what would make you think such a thing?
I don't know, I just feel it. It was him.
Oh, what would make Mr. Scrooge take leave of his senses?
Christmas.
Cratchit! Cratchit, there you are, Cratchit. What is the meaning of this, sir?
Mr. Scrooge, it's Christmas Day.
Cratchit? Why aren't you at the office?
Oh, Mr. Scrooge, I beg your pardon. I don't...
You didn't think I would come all the way down here to fetch you, did you? Well, I will not stand for this behavior any longer.
Tis Christmas Day!
Therefore, I must, I'm afraid I must.
Mr. Scrooge!
I must raise your salary.
What?
Are you feeling all right?
Oh, never better. I'm a new man. Merry Christmas, Bob.
Oh, Mr. Scrooge, I don't know what to say.
Oh, don't say anything. But you deserve a healthy raise. You scraped by long enough, my dear fellow. Merry Christmas to you and your family.
It was him. It was Mr. Scrooge who sent that enormous bird.
I still believe in Father Christmas, don't you? Tim, I want you to have something.
A half a crown!
Not just any half crown. It's my lucky half crown. I hope it will help you to get strong and well. Oh, the time I've wasted. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a Christmas skating party and dinner with my family. Wait a minute. Why don't you all come with me?
Would you like that, children?
Oh, I can't skate.
So fun.
Let's all go together and have a wonderful Christmas, shall we?
Oh, yes. Merry
Everyone,
Christmas.
Into the sleigh.
Yes. He's a comical old fellow. Why, with all that money, I'm sure every day is like Christmas. Oh!
Oh! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Ha ha! Every day will be Christmas.
Oh my!
Uncle Scrooge?
Fred, I was hoping that you would allow me to join your skating party and join you at dinner.
Absolutely, Uncle, and you're always welcome in our family, and not just for Christmas, but every day of the new year.
Ah, well, I'm a new man. The proof is in the pudding, as they say. And speaking of pudding, Mr. Topper, I understand that you are quite a skater. Well, I was good at it when I was a young man. Let's have a race, shall we? First one that jumps over the log gets the first dibs on the Christmas pudding, eh?
Hey, I can taste victory already!
Oh, I'm going to
win! And the winner is Uncle Scrooge!
Yes.
The winner is Christmas!
Yay!
Tim, come here, Tim. We're going to get you the finest doctors, and one day you'll be able to jump those logs better than me. Merry Christmas, everyone!
Merry Christmas! God bless us, everyone!
Yay!
God bless us!
The year and the play are over. And as for Scrooge, it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well if any man possessed the knowledge. Let that truly be said of each and every one of us. And as Tiny Tim observed,
God blesses everyone!
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.